Hello and welcome. In this demo, we'll be going over Azure Policy on AKS. Azure Policy helps to enforce organizational standards and to assess compliance at scale. Common use cases for policy include implementing governance for resource consistency, regulatory compliance, security, cost, and management. So let's get into the demo. So as you see, we have an AKS cluster in the Azure portal. So we can go to the policies on the left-hand side of the screen and click Go to Azure Policy, and then we can start assigning some policies. The first policy we will assign is temp disks and cache for agent node pools in AKS clusters should be encrypted at host. So as you see, we type it into the search box and it pops up. We can select it and then press Review and Create to assign it. We'll now assign a second policy. We'll again search through the policies that are predefined and choose Kubernetes cluster should not allow privileged containers. Again, we press Review and Create and assign it. For the third policy, we will search again like we have in the previous steps. And this time we'll search for Kubernetes clusters containers should only use allowed images. This time we'll click Next to bring up the policy configuration that we need to change. We can paste in our regular expression for our internal container registry and then click Create. We can then go back to the main page in the Azure portal for AKS and go to Workloads to see our pods running. So let's do that right now. As you see, all our pods are running and our cluster is healthy. So let's go into policies and see if anything has happened. As you can see, we have one violation. We can see that temp disks and cache for agent node pools in the AKS cluster should be encrypted at host has a policy violation. So we can click on it to get more information about it. So now we are going to test out our other two policies. So here is a YAML file that is going to deploy an unprivileged Nginx pod from a public repository. We can switch our kubeconfig to point to our production AKS cluster that we applied those other policies to. We can then run the kubectl get pods in all namespaces command to show that we have Azure Policy enabled. So now we can switch over to another YAML that has an Nginx pod that is privileged. And we can make sure that the security context that is privileged is set to true. When we then try to apply that pod, we can see what happens. As you see, we get the error from server message saying that the privileged container is not allowed. Our policy has just kicked in. We can now try it with the unprivileged pod and see what happens as well. As you can see, this was also not allowed as we are pulling this image from a public repository. We can then change the image tag to come from our internal container registry. After we do that, we can run the deployment again to see if it works. As you see, the pod was created as this satisfied our two policies, and now it is deployed to our cluster. If you want to learn more about Azure Policy on AKS, please visit our documentation. Thank you for watching.